A new sun has risen. Your song of life continues. You are very hungry. If you do not silence another living being and consume it soon. Is that like my old... Is that like my old scales? Let's go out into the open. You can still call upon Darktooth. Yeah, let's go start this day right by eating some foods. The several scents of the air, one familiar to this place, but a few others. Which will you follow? The familiar scent of death by Tailbeast. Let's try the familiar one first. Usually it's the safer, quote-quote, option. But death bite sounds really, sounds dangerous. Yeah. The taste of death by tail-based essence is upon the air. It makes no sign of acknowledgement. It seems not to know you are here. For at the moment, it is far from you. The wind favors you this hunt. The wind favors you this hunt. That sounds like a clue. The death by tail west is upwind from you. It will take longer for your scent to reach it. It makes no sign of acknowledgement. It seems not to know when you are here. It remains just yet on the edge of your senses, a great distance away. Let's draw nearer. You begin to taste fear. The betrayer and empowerer radiating from it. It is still possible to draw closer to it, but at this range you can make out its markings. Match a match, except he has more fire. Okay, I gotta go come closer. It knows it's a servant, flees. Let's chase after it. It's kind of weird that they made the snake coiled up as it's running. You have cornered the death by tail beast, and so begins a dance of destruction. Let's go bite. Light damage? Power strike. Okay, you deal moderate damage to the death by tail beast, and then moderate damage to me. And we are both battered. Let's try the power strike again. Death by tail beast deals light damage, and now the tail beast is crippled. Let's go for a swift strike. You have availed the dance of destruction. What will you do now with the now silent body of the death bite? Consume it raw. I'm gonna go roast it and then consume it, because I do remember that Darktooth did say that the death bite tailbeast has venom on it. You have lost a little energy. You bathe the now quiet Deathbite's body in your flame for a short time, burning away the toxic venom. The meal is now safe and surprisingly satisfying. You have gained some energy. This small fur beast of very pungent odor. The wind is not in your favor and carries your scent directly to your prey. You must move quickly if you wish to sneak up on it. Its scent is still free from the pungent smell of fear, even alertness. It is not very far away. If it dashes it now, it will be only several heartbeats. Strike! It notices you and flees! Your opponent is battered and worse of where your attacks are having an effect. You must now prepare for yourself for the dance of destruction, and you are also battered. I got moderate damage, what? And then your enemy is now injured. Power strike. The Lesser Sing Strike deals light damage to you, and now it is crippled. Your essence shot screams and you're now truly injured. By the way, like, I know that there's like patterns to their attacks, and I can't like... I'll probably still like, be keeping a notebook of their attack patterns and such, I can exploit it. Power strike, please! And that is that. You feel nourished. You have gained some energy. A small fur beast smelling of earth. Hey, it's the buddy! The wind has spoken to your nose and ears, bringing tidings of a long year in the area. Its scent is still free from the pungent smell of fear, or even alertness. It is not very far away. If it dashes it now, it will be several heartbeats. The wind is not in your favor and carries your scent directly to your prey. You must move quickly if you wish to sneak up on it. And it got us. I mean, I know we can actually, like... switch off the chase scenes, but might as well go for the full experience, right? Yeah. Let's start with an earth ability, which is like safe. And that is that. You have learned more about the way of the long ears and you've gained some energy, which is something we really need. Sun hangs low in the sky, signaling the end of this hunt. A new sun has risen, your song of life continues. Let's actually take it easy. Let's just explore, but let's not take too long. So this is a great green, huh? Let's explore down south and then sweep around and then fill in the center. Yes, please. A pond, strange human thing, and then another dragon. Water is enamored of this area and gathers in countless pools and marshes. Trees melt into grasses and cottontail plants. This area is dangerously close to a huge marsh known as the Empire of Reeds, an area claimed by a sapphire kid as its home. May hunt water beasts or request an audience with the Reed Lord, but perhaps other things may be found wet. May also be found in the wet and warm ward green. Thank you. let's not do the dragon. Let's go investigate this weird human thing again. Again, more of these bright sparkling people. They barely make any sound as they move from plant to plant, touching a leaf here, caressing a flower there with their long fingered forepaws, their small mouths. Their movements are measured and slow, as if every step, every gesture was carefully planned. They are brightlings. With their mostly hairless and tailed bodies and stilt-like legs, they bear some resemblance to the other seed species, such as the no-tails and the delvers, but they are altogether different in scent and in spirit. A facade of no-tailed birder scent cannot hide from their true aroma, which is like blackberries and lightning, holding not the slightest trace of decay. Each of their scents are exactly alike. As for their inner essence, you cannot see the elemental spirit lines of their true selves at all, but rather, their whole bodies seem to glow faintly. Are they made entirely out of tiny spirit lines, or do they have no true essence at all? Both seem impossible. At the moment, these three are engaged in touching, smelling, and occasionally even tasting every tree and plant they come across. They never destroy anything, although occasionally they pick up a fallen leaf or pull up a small herb or flower whole, still with its roots and soil, and then place them in a small sphere of melted sand briefly before carefully placing them back where they are. What will you do? Approach them openly and interact with them. Silently observe them, hunt one, and avoid them. Let's say hi. As you approach, one notices you, and then all three are suddenly looking at you with piercing violet eyes. The first sang no warning to the others and made no sign. How did they know? It is as though they share one mind. Because you cannot see where their minds are, you have difficulty singing to them in the usual way. There's no surface upon which to paint your feelings and ideas. However, they do not quail or shy away from you. The scent of fear is truly absent here, which is in itself more than a little disturbing. As one, they slowly approach you, their forepaws outstretched. It seems that they wish to touch your head. In a moment, their digits will be upon you. What will you do? I'm gonna allow them to touch me. Despite a feeling of rising fear, you remain stationary and allow them to touch you. You feel a jolt, a spark as they make contact, but you are unhurt. They proceed to gently inspect you, smelling your skin. One even uses its small pink tongue to taste your crown feathers. Might their tongues be as sensitive as yours? They back away and stand still for several moments and then return to their prior investigation of the green, ignoring you. Many questions follow you to the back of your lair. Is that they neither fear you nor prey upon you? Why do they wish to touch your body? Like the no-tails, the brightlings are mysterious, but a total lack of understandable intentions makes them even more fearful. You have gained some Earth Mastery. I use Sun is Risen, your Song of Flow continues. How's my status like? You are hungry. Your core sings a growing song of emptiness occasionally to remind you of your duty as a destroyer of all life. Let's go try to catch a fish. A fish, yes. Several scents in the air, one familiar to this place, but a few others. Which will you follow? You encounter a shift scale foraging for food, following the way of its people. It is, as of yet, ignorant of you. It is not very far away. If you dash at it now, it'll be only several heartbeats. The wind is not in your favor and carries your scent directly to your prey. Ah, let's move closer. Let's try the large scale beast lurking in the water. Your keen senses have revealed the presence of a long scale here. You begin to taste fear, the betrayal, and the power radiating from it. Its body and yours are nowhere near each other. I'm gonna go observe first because it's fearful. Its head is raised and alert. Clearly it senses something is amiss. It's not in clear sight yet. Still far away. That's red. It makes no sign of acknowledgement. It seems not to know where you are here. A great distance still remains to close before you are near it. Let's silently draw nearer. And then it's gone. Seriously, man, water hunting is hard. How about a feather beast smelling of water? I need to eat something, man, I'm hungry. The wind has spoken to your nose and ears, bringing tidings of a snow feather in the area. No sign of acknowledgement. Doesn't know that you're here. A great distance still remains to close before you're near to it. The wind favors you this hunt. The snow feathers will upwind from you. It will take longer for your scent to reach it. Let's draw closer. It has paused and is actively scanning its surroundings. Still possible to draw closer to it, but in this range you can make out its markings. Holy crap, they are actually strong! Strike! A snow feather winks away, escaping your grasp. And then the dragon returns hungry. I have weak fire stat, though. That's very sad, it's like. You are hungry. Let's go explore. This sacred cathedral of trees, some of which are said to be as old as the Great Green itself, is known to all as the home of the Spirit of the Green. His name is referred even by the drag, and is the basis of the name for your entire territory. Only a fool would enter this area, the sacred Glen, with anything but utmost respect and trepidation. But then, from nothing, you stop short of entering your lair. There's a potent smell wafting from the cave, gray, green, and odious. Cautiously, you step inside, and looking up, you realize that the ceiling is moving, little waves rippling across the surface. The cave is full of featherless flying fur beasts, shriekers, thousands of them. They sing impossibly high songs to each other, a mess of sound which tickles your mind. Despite their having been here for a short time, their leavings cover the floor. Watching you, they seem to be waiting for your next move. Attempt to decipher a strange singing. Shriekers are not bad to eat, make a meal of it. Use their flame to incinerate the polluting interlopers. Let's try to attempt to decipher this. Try as you might, you can't understand what they are singing. It seems to be full of paradoxes and non sequiturs. Perhaps they're trying to warn you away, perhaps they're blabbing in fear, or perhaps they're insulting you. You cannot be sure. My next move is to just burn them. Not fancying the idea of your treasure being regularly blanked upon by shriekers, you belch up the fire seed and breathe it outward. A single blast should be enough to convince them to leave and never return. Oh, what the crap! What that was, then you learned that the waste material produced by shriekers is explosive. Oh, holy crap! You got blasted! The shriekers attempt to fly away, but some are caught in a blast and stumble, squeaking and clicking, to the cave floor. You're knocked backwards by the force, points of light stabbing through the darkness behind your eyes. You stumble quite a ways, and the hard landing brings even more pain. Your fire has been reflected back upon yourself. Dazed and wounded, you are first afraid to enter the lair, but as moon rises, there are clearly neither sound nor scent of the intruders left. You have infected them quite forcefully, and they will almost surely not return. Not all your treasures survive the blast, though you learn something about not using your flame as a first resort in a familiar situation, and are tougher for having survived an explosion. A large amount of earth mastery! I am wounded bad. Nine shiny things, Crystal Fang and Lodestone. I lost like 20 of them. I am actually critical health. That was on full HP as well. No choice but to sit down. Take it easy for a day. A new sun has risen, your song of life continues, and we're badly injured. We must sleep a bit. I mean, as I love to explore that fiasco with the bats was devastating. Rest is indeed wise. A new sun has risen, your song of life continues. You are very hungry. Now let's go, let's get out there and start hunting. Yeah. Let's stick with the easy ones for now. Let's go get some tail bite. You encounter a death bite tail beast foraging for food, following the ways of its people. It seems completely oblivious to their presence. It is not yet in clear sight, yet still far away. The wind is not in your favor and carries your scent directly to your prey. Let's grow closer. His head raised and alert. Clearly it senses something is amiss. It's still possible to draw closer to it, but at this range you can make out its markings. I need to raise my fire sigil. Keep still and observe. It said raise an alert. Clearly it says that something is amiss. Let's silent still. You begin to taste fear, betrayer, and empower radiating from it. Let's keep still. It notices you and flees. Okay. Let's use Earth Bite. Your enemy is now injured. Yeah, let's. Okay, so. Actually, you know what? I can actually gonna start writing down some notes for these enemies. Because right now I'm just throwing stuff at the wall, seeing if it sticks. Let's see. And I'm gonna make my own bestiary of sorts. Tail beast. First attack with air. Let's try power slam. Power strike. Oh no! Water won! Air, water. Let's try Earth. Air, water, Earth. Oh no! What did you do with the now silent body of the Deathbite? If only your mind was sharper or you knew more of the Deathbite clan. That's because I was injured. Unfortunately, our option is to only consume is raw. While the taste is not bad, your core begins to object shortly after you swallow the poisonous goodbeast. The unpleasant feeling spreads, you feel awful. You've learned more about the way of the death by tail beasts. You've gained some energy. How about the moderately sized tail beast? Let's see. The wind has spoken to your nose and ears, bringing tidings of a light sky claw in the area. Head is raised and alert. It senses something amiss. The wind is not in my favor. Observe. Its body and yours are nowhere near each other, and it's not ignorant of the fact that danger may be near. God, I need more mastery. You begin to taste fear, the betrayer, and empower radiating from it. Its body and yours are nowhere near each other. It seems completely oblivious to their presence. Its body and yours are nowhere near each other. Let's draw nearer. This one is red. The night claw winks. The night sky claw winks away, escaping your grasp. If only I had wings, right? Oh, holy crap! My stats are like massively reduced. How about the fur beast with a predator's scent? Oh, holy crap! Lesser lumberer in the area. It has paused and is actively scanning its surroundings. His body and yours are nowhere near each other. The wind favors you this hunt. Okay. Let's stay still. Its head is raised and alert. Clearly, it senses something is amiss. Let us stay still. Its scent is still free from the pungent smell of fear, or even alertness. It's not in clear sight, still far away. Let's draw nearer. Oh, what's the stats? Holy crap! We will be massively hammered if we did. Sun hangs low in the sky, signaling the end of this hunt.